このチャンネルで癒しの祈りを受けて癒された方がいらっしゃいましたらご連絡ください。また先生の癒しの祈りを受けたい方は遠慮なくご相談とご連絡くださいますようお願いいたします。
Thank you, mommy. We are mommy. Seventy-three years we've been with the shepherd. 73 years mommy has been with the shepherd. A happy story of the shepherd and sheep. The day when Mommy members become one is coming. 2019 Mommy Summer Retreat.
이 시간 이곳을 주목하고 계십니다.
생명의 말씀으로 renewed by the word of life. Fervent by the fiery words of power.
하나됨으로
being united, full of grace.
우리의 마음의 향을
we'll offer up the aroma of our hearts to Father God.
2019
Mommy Summer Retreat.
함께 참여하기를 사모하는
We took the first step to the world. 주님을 향한 열정과 We are together by passion and fervor towards the Lord. It was an inexpressible touching time. Joy and passion in Indonesia. Although we speak different languages, we became one. It made me very happy. I thought I wanted to go to heaven with them together. Emotion and tears towards the souls in Indonesia. It was not always easy, but it was time that I recovered thanks and joy. The fruit of the power grown in Indonesia. I'm so grateful that I could be there at the scene of power. I want to become a person like Pastor Holy Star Lee, serving also in other countries. Mamin in the world, seminary students standing on the runway. A touching story for 9 days in Indonesia. Let's go to New Jerusalem. Mamin Church, I love you. Let's go into the scene of 2019 United Holiness Seminary Students short-term mission trip to Indonesia. Fourteen students with the key role of juniors of the seminary. They were full of expectation and passion because it was their first mission trip. Mission trip team, go, go! We left Incheon Airport and arrived at Jakarta, the capital city of Indonesia. Welcome, welcome. We welcome, we love you and welcome you. We welcome you. I love you and welcome you. We arrived very late, but the pastor and youth from GPDI Hosanna Narada Church in partnership with us warmly welcomed us. Good. It's sweet and good. It's really delicious. The population of Indonesia is 2.7 billion and it ranks at the fourth populated country in the world. 87% of them are Muslims and only 10% are Christians. It is not easy to live as a Christian in the society of Muslims. Let's look into the life of Indonesian Christians. Our team's first schedule started. We gathered at the church to visit the church members. The chief police officer of Johor Bahru visited the church to see and welcome us. He was happy for our visit and was interested in Korea. We left the church with anticipation. to meet the members.
저희는 세 팀으로 나누어
We were divided into three teams and visited 18 homes in total.
현지 성도님들
They received us in a very warm manner.
짧은 시간 믿음을
We shared the word of God to plant them faith and prayed with the handkerchief of power. Then they were moved and shed tears. We hoped we would reach the beautiful heaven with them together. And we shared our testimonies, seeing them who lived their Christian life in a difficult situation, we were deeply touched.
떨어진 한국에서
I thank the brothers and sisters from Korea for visiting my home and praying for me. And I thank you for your message. I was very happy when I heard of it. You are all our friends. I want you to visit Indonesia again and spend time with us. I long to visit Korea and will pray for that.
아침부터
We were busy even in the morning. We gathered and prepared something. Missionary Java, what are you doing now? We are preparing for Korean Day.
그렇습니다.
Yes. Today is the day of Korean Day, Mamin Day. We prepared foods and arranged Mamin ministry desk. And we hung the clothes and tried to play tohu game. Korean Day, Mamin Day is ongoing. We welcome you to Hosanna Narada Church. Hallelujah. It was an evangelism event to invite neighbors because it is not easy to evangelize in a Muslim country. Those whom we met yesterday and many people participated in Korean Day, Mamin Day. It's so delicious. We ate tteokbokki and drank plum juice and were Korean traditional dress hanbok. We took a picture wearing Korean hanbok in the background of heaven picture. A smiling child looking at the camera. We wore a Korean traditional dress hanbok, very cool. Tried the Korean shuttlecock kicking game. We made a pretty card to write a Bible verse in Korean on. We also introduced our ministry we are proud of as a seminary student. The reaction of the locals to tasting the Muan Sui water was very hot. Their interest in Korea naturally led to Christian faith of Koreans and became a meaningful opportunity to introduce Mamin. We heard the story of Muan Sui water where seawater turned into drinkable water through prayer. Through this, I realized that God can do anything. This is what actually happened, and I believe that God is working best for us. The Korean youth were very kind to us. I could feel warm love through them. It felt like a one family. And I could feel the sincerity of loving, praising, and serving God so much. I really liked this. I love Korea. I love Hosanna. I love Mommy. Hallelujah. Today is the time to get closer to my local friends. We prepared this athletic meet discussing with the local youth in advance while we are in Korea. Even though the countries are different and the communication is not so good, we are united through the games. The first game is jumping a rope in a group. Victory will be won by the team who jumps over it the most within a minute. We'll show you the strengths of our home grounds. Narada Church's youth are as good at the game as our mission team. They jumped as many as 23. The yellow team goes for it with a resolute determination. Would it be better to face each other? Unfortunately, they jumped 21. So the rope jumping game was won by the red team who jumped 23 times. This is a turn of adults. Failure from the start. Our adults who cannot jump even one. That's what we guessed. This time we really do this right. 1, 2, 3. Who was a big hole among the adult team? They gave a big smile to the students and walking out. In addition, through various games, it was a time of recharging power in their journey toward the New Jerusalem, dreaming of the day to enjoy in heavens with eternal happiness. Now, let us announce the result. 1, 2, 3, yellow team. The winning team was given a gift set of Korean sweets and ramen noodles. We are so happy to be with Manmin mission team since they visited here. It was my first time to be with Koreans, and I was impressed with their kindness and devotion to God's kingdom. Thank you for being a good example for Hosanna Church's youth. I was very happy to be with Korean young adults today, and especially thank you for your visiting my home. Although languages and cultures are different, I could feel how much they love Indonesia. I'm happy and glad to be with them. I cannot forget today. Manmin mission team, go for it. I love you. We headed for Bokashi Bethlehem Church. This is a church ministered by Pastor Adrian Saro Insong and his wife, whoever led the team to our church last May. The local youth were praising enthusiastically. We also praised fervently and became full of first love when he met the Lord and first heart when he entered the seminary. This time was to see our mission team at the stage. The local youth continued to take photos by their cell phones, not to miss any good scene from their eyes. There was also a time of listening to the testimonies of our seminary students. Brother Seonggyul Park and Sister Yujin Im shared the grace of how they've been changed to become a seminary student and the testimonies of healing by senior pastor. I have had epilepsy since I was 60 years old. So even though I took a medicine, I had the symptoms and collapsed. When this symptom occurred, I passed out within 2 minutes. Then in 2017, I attended the summer retreat of Mamim Central Church, and the senior pastor taught me how to heal it. That is, to read the book of the message of cross and to break down the wall of sin between God and me. And I got prepared to be answered. So on the day of the summer retreat, I received the prayer of senior pastor on the stage, and then my heart became peaceful. This piece was a very important proof because I was afraid that if I did not take medicine, I would always collapse. Now, every time I share my testimony with people, I think I give the hope that they can be also be healed. So my life became so precious. I hope that you will not lose even small things, but you will give thanks to Father God in your lips. In the grace that Father God poured like waterfall, we embraced each other with tears and prayed. Although we prayed in other languages, we could feel the same works in the Holy Spirit. We were filled with the Holy Spirit that cannot be filled anywhere in the world, and we shared enthusiasm with each other, praising more fervently. Today's blessing came to everyone who was in the praise worship service. The mission team's praise and dance were very impressive. Through their testimony, we have received great grace, especially when the seminary students were praying for us in their arms. We were filled with the Holy Spirit and could meet God fervently. On the last Sunday of June, we divided into two teams and led handkerchief prayer meetings in local churches. We could experience full-scale power of God at the scene with Pastor Holy Star Lee and Pastor Seonggyul Park. The speaker preached each spiritual meaning on the cross, proclaiming that only Jesus Christ is our Savior. then the reaction of the local believers was hot. Especially when the power of God video clip was presented, the cheers and applause of the local people filled the sanctuary. After the message, we could feel the Father God with us. Many people were healed of pain, knee, eyesight recovery, shoulder pain, and others through the prayer of the power of the handkerchief. We glorify God by sharing many healing testimonies. I had pain in my leg until yesterday. I want to show you my condition now. I had been in pain for 26 years because of my leg pain. My wife knows better than anyone else about it. I often cried out because my pain was so severe, and I did not let anyone touch my legs. I did not let them even get closer to me. Because of the pain, I could not walk properly in my workplace, and I have limped. But today, after I received the prayer from the pastor, my pain has gone. I praise God. No matter how hard I hit it, I do not feel pain at all. I have experienced an amazing healing work today. The pain was so severe that I could not move my shoulders freely, but I could feel that pain disappeared after I received the prayer from the pastor today. Now I can lift up my hand like this and freely move it also. Through the prayer of the speaker, God has healed me. Glory to Father God. Hallelujah.
이곳은 만민의
This is 땅그랑 땅그랑 만민 Branch Church. Actually, this is a neighborhood where Muslims are so extreme that Christians are so persecuted that they have to wrap their Bibles with newspaper. The church members keep their faith and ride in the flow of Manmin even in difficult circumstances. Manmin was one. We are Manmin. We would not go to paradise, not the first kingdom of heaven, not the second kingdom of heaven, not the third kingdom of heaven, only New Jerusalem. Amen. I felt their sincere hearts. We prayed together and we were moved in tears. Thank you. We were filled with hope for the most beautiful heaven, the hope of New Jerusalem, and the handkerchief prayer meeting continued. We prayed earnestly for them, one by one, so that they may live a happy life in the shepherd's face. Through the prayer of the power of handkerchief, they were blessed with the healings of headache, aftermath of traffic accident, shoulder pain, and others. After giving birth to my second daughter, I suffered from headache every night. Because of the headache, I could not sleep properly without taking medicine. So I took the medicine last night also. However, after I came to church today and received the prayer of Pastor Hyungyeol Park, my headache all disappeared. I felt hot just when the pastor prayed for my head. My body immediately became lighter. It was a great joy and blessing for us to have the seminary students in Indonesia. And they especially visited Sangrang Mami Church. It has been a more blessed time for us. Through this meeting, many of our church members were happy to be healed, and we felt that the Central Church and we are one in the Lord. So I am proud to be missionary of Mami. Mami, I love you. Thank you. We are Mami. Hallelujah. In the evening, on that day, there was a handkerchief healing meeting in Hosanna Narada Church. The healing meeting was started with the praise of local youth, added with the fullness of the Spirit through the special praise of the mission team. Pastor Holy Star Lee delivered the message with the title of Spiritual Faith and Fleshly Faith, and the participants listened to him saying Amen. The believers who were prepared to be answered through the message were eager to receive the prayer with the handkerchief on which Senior Pastor prayed. We seminary students also did our duties in various areas during the meeting, hoping that the power of God would be manifested more abundantly. Foot pain healed, throat cancer healed, thigh healed, head pain relief, hip bone pain healed, right hand pain and foot pain healed, severe pain from vertebral fracture. Before I came here, I was so sick that I could not come to church because my headache was so severe. But I came here with faith today. I have received so much grace when the message about faith was given by Pastor Holy Star Lee. And when the pastor prayed for me, my tears streamed down continually. Because I was eager to increase my faith as well as healing today. Today I've been healed and have received great grace. Hallelujah. Among them, I saw a child who could not walk from his birth, but after receiving the prayer, he came to walk step by step. My grandson Samuel Nathaniel is 3 years old. From his birth, he could not walk at all and could not speak. Today, however, by the blessing of God, an amazing miracle happened here. My grandson, after receiving the prayer, could walk for the first time. This made my faith grow up. God is so great. Praise the mighty God. After the handkerchief healing meeting, shaking hands with each of the attendees, we filled our hearts with the impression and grace of the day. The last event of the short-term mission trip was a seminar for pastors. This seminar was very important for Mami's mission in Indonesia. It's because a place of spiritual alliance for evangelization of Indonesia, introducing Mami ministry and sharing our visions with the pastors who are ministering in Indonesia. There were many pastors who did not forget the impression of having visited our church in May. Before I go to Korea, my doctor told me I needed knee surgery. But I came to Korea and received a prayer from Pastor Susan Lee. He prayed for me with the handkerchief of power on which Reverend Gerald Lee prayed. And then I went down the stairs. Whenever I went downstairs, it was painful because of the knee pain. But after receiving the prayer, an amazing thing happened. I said to my daughter, I have no pain in my leg. God healed me. This is a miracle. People around me looked at me because they knew I had pain in my legs. I have never had any pain since I received the prayer. I praise the Lord. About 150 people attended. That is more than twice as many as we initially expected. They were looking forward to hearing message. Pastor Holy Star delivered the message entitled The Power of God. The powerful works that came through Senior Pastor were the answer to all. Watching the video Power of God, I could feel the power of God manifest in all parts of the world through the ministry of Dr. Gerald Lee. As I saw many people being healed, I realized how much we need the power of God, and I believe that Dr. Lee's ministry will grow much more in the future. I'm grateful to Manmin Central Church for fully supporting this event. Thank you so much for giving our members new strengths to be more faithful in serving God. I would like to thank all the seminary students who prepared with their hearts and strengths for this event. We love Manmin Central Church. Praise the Lord. In May, I visited Manmin Central Church together with about 120 pastors. And for the 3 days, our loving seminary students served us. We are truly blessed people. We have seen that Manmin Church is a church that truly loves God. We have experienced the unity of love in Manmin Church. The most amazing thing was the prayers of Manmin. We attended the Daniel Prayer Meeting and prayed with the members of Manmin Church together. We could see the thousands of believers praying together. We could see that Manmin Church grew into a big church because of the members praying every night. And Manmin members have tried to be sanctified. Reverend Gerald Lee has been ministering so that everyone can be saved through Jesus Christ. We earnestly want Reverend Gerald Lee come to Indonesia and hold a crusade. Manmin Central Church, we love you. Hallelujah. A 9-day mission trip, we are now standing at the last moment. I have seen that their minds are ready to believe in God and seek to find God, but they have not yet heard the gospel, so they became Muslims or have other religions without knowing God rightly. In this situation, I thought that it is important what kinds of words they hear and what kinds of gospel they receive. So it was time for me to realize the word of the senior pastor who said that we should awaken more souls and fulfill our mission work abroad. As I looked at those who love our church so much, I realized again, Mamin is truly a church in the world and will do great things of Father God. When I remember that time, I realized that God has guaranteed us in His space, because all the praises were done not by myself, but by the name of Mamin and the senior pastor. Even though I am very small, I realize that with this little talent I have, I can be somebody for the senior pastor and for Mamin. Now that the roots of the gospel are deeply embedded, I hope that many people in Indonesia will preach the word of God with bigger responsibility, and the gospel of holiness is planted more deeply. I hope that without forgetting this precious experience, I want to be a prepared worker in the Canaan Sanctuary in the future. We are born in the second generation of Mamin and entered the seminary now. We went abroad in the name of Mamin and took our first step. We went directly to the mission field, preaching the works of God's power and Holy Gospel, and practicing what we had been taught, crying and laughing together during the mission trip. We have grown up to the next step, where the impossible will be made possible. We will surely join the great plan of Father God toward Mamin, the wonderful ministry of Mamin all over the world. Please remember us and look forward to Mamin's bright future seminary students.